Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Wallace Wade Stadium in Durham, North Carolina, named after one of the great coaches in the history of the sport. Today, these two teams getting set to square off. Plenty of paint will be swapped on those headgears as we go head-to-head in Durham. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
Wade Stadium, located here in the old North State, North Carolina.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Whitfield fields it at the 11. He's taken down at the 40.
Texas State's coaching staff so confident they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big playability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five wide set. He steps out at the 45. Cox gets him about 3 yards with a completion. Third down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
There's nothing better for a defense's mindset than to get a three and out. I mean, a turnover, of course, is a positive play, and a coach will take that any day of the week. But to know you've stopped the best their offense has to offer for three straight plays, that's a confidence builder.
When you face a defense that blitzes both corners, they're basically coming up and saying to you, hey, we're going to come after you and after you and after you until you show us that you can stop it.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Out to around the 35. Nice game for the halfback.
That time they kept it on the ground with the counter play. The blocking was great up front, and the tailback was able to get into the open field and do some special things.
Tackle at the 49. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
He's hit immediately in the backfield. So it's second and 13. Ball on the 46-yard line. And now he's got room to run. Brought down around the 42-yard line. On the play. This is two. Davis.
He'd like to change field position with his punt. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. He's on the run. They'll bring him down right around the 20. The Bobcats have one of the most dangerous offensive weapons in the entire country under center today. This kid is really fun to watch. He's fun to watch unless you're a defensive coordinator. One thing's for sure, it's going to be a great chess match between the offensive and defensive coordinators today. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
From their own 20-yard line, it's third down. He sails it long. He's tackled right around the 30.
That makes it first and 10.
Let's go, defense. Let's go, defense. And here we go. 50's the mic. 50's the mic.
Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it. The defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. He's at the 20. He makes his way out to about the 6.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? He better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
Touchdown, Bobcats. And he adds the extra point. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
Time to check in on Rustin.
It felt as if the game rested on every play.
The Bulldogs take it by 5.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Texas State gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. At the 30. Knocked out of bounds at the 34-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. To about the 37-yard line.
Gaining 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Roger, Roger! Check, I'm free for Mike, I'm free for Mike. You ain't doing nothing. What is?
Boy, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, and somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
From their own 37-yard line, third down. They'll give it off here. Tackle made at the 38.
That'll bring up 4th and 5.
Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. The ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
And they make the stop right around the 42-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Texas State up 7 points. Runs it, and he stops short of the line of scrimmage. down now, and they need to get it down to the 31.
Going for it all to the end zone. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. He tried to force it to a man that wasn't open, and boy, was he lucky it wasn't picked off.
He's got to be more careful when throwing the football into the end zone.
Kelly can pin him deep in their own territory with a good punt here. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. Texas State defense is playing lights out right now, pitching a shutout.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. Just the way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, there's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
And he's tackled right around the 44-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Oh, we had a pitcher's duel in that low-scoring first quarter. The Bobcats with a touchdown lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
Let's go!
Got some open field.
Nice run to the outside. Good run by the quarterback.
The thing that impresses me is the decision making. He sees it opening, decides to turn it upfield, and gets a nice gain and a first down.
Take him down immediately.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch. That's fun to see.
Throw's complete. He's got room to work. He's taken down at about the 15-yard line. Taken down around the 14-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
And down he goes at about the 11.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
He's going to try and scramble, and he's going to come up with a sack.
That is a loss of 4 yards. That brings us 4th and 11.
Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. It's up, and he got it. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Taken from the 3-yard line. And he's taken down at the 25-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Texas State holds a 4-point lead. Gains his way to the 40-yard line.
Called a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Here we go, here we go. Tight right. Cool down. Hey, Mike's 50. Catch 13.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Called a gain of 7 yards. That makes it 2nd and 2.
There's a strike complete. Tackle right around the 36-yard line.
makes it first and 10.
Four down, Mike 50. Sack, green 19.
Runs it and tackled in the backfield.
You know, as a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you, and that's what happened.
And he's hit immediately.
Bell makes the tackle at the 30-yard line. That'll bring up third and four.
Deep ball, laying it out there. Got his man. Touchdown. And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
That's perfect timing between a quarterback and his wide receiver. He recognized the middle of the field was wide open, and I really thought the quarterback kind of looked the safety off to open that play up to the middle and then made the perfect throw for the touchdown.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. It's fielded at the 2. They'll bring him down at the 24-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. One play, and he'll lose yards.
Loss of four. That makes it second and 14.
It's second down now, and 14 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Fires that quickly to the tailback. Brought down around the 23-yard line. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Little screen pass, but he can't hang on to the ball.
Miles was the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Whitfield, back to return it. He dropped it.
I know I'd be nervous with 11 guys sprinting down the field to me, but the first job of a return man is to catch the ball.
The main thing is they got the ball back, and now they can go to work on offense. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense.
Allen on the tackle at the 32-yard line. That'll bring up second and 3.
Hey, Mike's 50, Mike's 50. Larry. Red 18. Thunder.
Get to that quickly, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. It's third and 5. Ball on the 33. Gets out to around the 25.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
The Bobcats are going to call their second timeout. Now he tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down at about the 23-yard line.
Omaha, Omaha.
his hands. The wide receiver wasn't able to hang on.
Well, you talk about a solid hit. This guy is a true enforcer.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Throws it to the halfback on the screen.
Loss of 10 yards on the play. That makes it fourth and long.
He's got it. Touchdown. And for Williams, he gets his second touchdown in the passing game.
The quarterback knew exactly where to put the pass, and the receiver went out there and made the grab. Good communication there.
He makes the PAT. No surprises here as we come to the end of the first half. The Bobcats with an 18-point cushion.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, trying to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He sends this one deep. Tackle at the 19. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gets out to about the 21. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. At the 35. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
Touch on that pass.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down.
Here we go.
incomplete. Brought down. Nothing doing. Nothing gained on the play.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
Davis is the punter. Whitfield takes it to 28. He's taken down at the 37. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. And got him to the 20. Tackle made at the 13-yard line. He's got 100 yards in the game now.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
And now he's got room to run. Touchdown, Bobcats. Quarterback just showed us he can beat you with his feet as well as his arm.
And what a dangerous weapon this guy is.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Mundy looks ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Texas State's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill when they can attack this offense.
And they make the stop at about the 31. One out to the left. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. That's good enough for another two. First down.
Get him.
Throws complete and he stopped immediately. Around the 26-yard line. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. That's a loss of about three.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Second and 13.
From the 29-yard line, it's second down. Gets it out to his receiver, and he can't hang on.
Pierre was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it third and 13.
First down, and he's out of bounds.
That's good enough for another two.
Right.
Navajo!
And they got him for a loss.
You know, it looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
So we're looking at another third down here. Is out to the tailback on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds at the one. That's a deep play. He dives and he'll be marked down. Taken down around the 4-yard line.
That's a loss of 3 yards on the play. That makes it third and goal.
Here we go, folks. Third and goal from the 4. And he's taken down at the 2-yard line.
Gaining 2 yards. That brings up fourth and goal.
Let's go.
So at the end of the third quarter, the Bobcats in front, 28-3. Not sure there's any hope for a comeback here in the fourth quarter, but Kirk and I are praying. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage.
I'm not sure the offense had much of a choice here. It was a pretty short conversion. The defense just made a good play.
Really a great stop by the defense. This will go down as one of those critical plays. Early in the fourth quarter, and this one we know is over. It's an opportunity for some subs to play on one side and maybe to play for pride on the other. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Second and six.
Second down and six. Ball on the 10. Texas State up big. Makes it to the 12-yard line.
That's good for 2 yards. That'll bring up third and four.
Down he goes at the 21-yard line.
Called a gain of 9 yards. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 21. Tackle at the 33.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. First down.
Throw. Brought down at the 45-yard line.
Allen with the tackle at the 45-yard line. That makes it first.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45. Five wide. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 43-yard line.
First down.
Off, and he's met immediately. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Just over 2 minutes in the game. for a nice game.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it 39.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33. Tackles him for a loss.
James takes him down behind the line. Fourth down.
He's going to try to coffin corner this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Texas State defense, they've got the it factor.
The it factor, the swagger, whatever you want to call it. When they take the field, they know they're better than you. And it's a group of 11, they play like they know they're going to stop you.
You just hope that a game this uneven ends quietly. We don't want to see anything nasty and pointless at the end. Fires complete over the middle. He is drilled at the 29.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Under a minute left in the game. Caught with room to work. They'll bring him down at about the 33-yard line. Duke will have one timeout remaining. From their own 29-yard line. Second down. Picked off, and that's going to wrap this one up.
Can these guys do anything right? I mean, they're already getting blown out, and now another interception? This is just one of those days.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Favorite play in football if you're a quarterback. Take a knee. And the ball game's over. And our final score in this one, 28-3, Texas State. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.